Thank you to all who participated in this activity. As you can see, we got maximum votes for bee colony optimization algorithm. So in this video, we will discuss all about bee colony optimization algorithm, plus what is artificial bee colony optimization algorithm and how we can solve this algorithm step by step with a numerical example. Topics covered in this video. First, basic introduction about honeybees, different algorithms inspired by bees' behavior, bee algorithm role in solving different problems, what is bee colony optimization algorithm, what is artificial bee colony optimization algorithm, and how we can solve this algorithm step by step with numerical example. In nature, there exist a large number of different social insect species, and they are all capable of performing a variety of complex tasks. In previous videos, we already discussed a number of algorithms based on the behavior of different insects. For example, fruit fly optimization algorithm, dragonfly optimization algorithm, firefly optimization algorithm, ant colony optimization algorithm. In this video, we will discuss about bee colony optimization algorithm that is inspired by the behavior of honeybees in the nature. Bees are the flying insects with wings like this. You can see this is beehive, and it contains 60,000 to 80,000 living elements. Inside bee colony, there is one reproductive female known as queen, few males approximate 1,000 known as drones, many sterile females known as workers. In real life, honeybees collect and process nectar, and this is highly organized practice. They use nectar as energy source for their survival, and nectar is collected in the pollen baskets situated in their legs. And how each bee reach the nectar sources in the real life? They follow their nest mates who already discovered a patch of flowers. You can see a number of algorithms inspired by the behavior of bees. For example, beehives, bee colony optimization algorithm, artificial bee colony optimization algorithm, marriage in honeybee colony. We can use bee system to solve different genetic problems, beehive to solve different routing protocols problems. Honeybee marriage can be used for cluster analysis. Bee colony optimization can be used for solving traveling salesman problem, vehicle routing problem, ride matching problem, and job scheduling problem. We can use artificial bee colony optimization to solve different numerical optimization problems and engineering problems. First, we will discuss about bee colony optimization algorithm. This is a meta-heuristic algorithm that is inspired by the behavior of bees in the nature, and we have certain features for this algorithm. For example, nectar exploration, bagel dance, food foraging, division of bees, and mating during flight. And bee colony is based on three different models: food foraging, and after food foraging, nest site search, and marriage in the bee colony. Now we have main algorithm, that is the artificial bee colony optimization algorithm. This is inspired by the bee colony optimization algorithm. This is a population based meta heuristic algorithm based on the intelligent behavior of honeybee colony. In artificial bee colony optimization algorithm is combined with both local and global search And you can use this algorithm to solve different engineering problems. And in this algorithm, bees or agents that are the artificial bees are searching for rich artificial food sources, and artificial food sources are good solutions that we will compute for each bee. Artificial bee colony optimization algorithm provide better results as compared to particle swarm optimization algorithm. Sometimes particle swarm optimization provide inaccurate results. Using artificial bee colony, we can obtain better results as compared to PSO. In artificial bee colony optimization algorithm, bees are divided into three groups. First is honey bee or employee bee. Second is followers or onlooker bees. Third is scout. Employee bees search for the nectar, or you can say employee bees search for the food sources information from the surrounding, and then employee bees will share this information with the followers or onlooker bees. In real life, honey bees perform dance ceremony, that is the bagel dance, to notify other bees quality of food sources they have been collected. And third is scout bees. The follower. As we know, employee bees search for the nectar or food sources, then follower select the bee with the better nectar information, and after that we have scout bees. Scout bees are the honey bees that abandon nectar and search for new sources of nectar, or we can say they explore their own food sources. This is the simple pseudo code for this algorithm. First we have initialization phase, and we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met. First phase is employee bees phase. Up next, follower bees phase, scout bees phase, and memorize the best solution achieved. In the first step, we will initialize the population randomly for each bee. After that, we will compute the fitness value for each agent or bee in the population. In step 3, memorize the best solution in the population. Set the current iteration 1. Step 5, generate new solution for the employee bee from the old solution. Here you can see this is the employee bee phase. So first we will generate the new solution for the employee bees from the older solution that we obtain here. After that, we will compute the fitness value for all new solution in the population and keep the best solution. In step 8, we will compute the probability for the solution, and after that we will generate new solution for the follower bees from the solution selecting depending on its probability values, and after that again compute the fitness value for all new solution in the population, and then determine the abandoned solution if exists and replace it with the new randomly selected solution. Keep the best solution found in the population, and then increment the counter, and we repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met. Now let's see how this algorithm is working step by step with an example. First, we have key points for this algorithm. In this algorithm, nectar or food sources are the solution that are associated with the each employee bees. and nectar or food source quality is determined by the fitness value. So for each employee bee, we will compute the fitness value, and by that we can determine the food source quality. Best solution means solution with the greatest fitness value. So step one is initialization phase. Here, initialize the population randomly. Suppose we have population size 4 and maximum number of iteration 100, and we have total decision variables 5, lower bound minus 10, upper bound 10. And this is the initial population that we generated for 4 search agents or 4 bees. And you can see all the values are within the bound. You can see the lower bound and the upper bound, minus 10 and 10. And you can see this is the initial population generated for 4 search agents. After that, using a fitness function, we will compute the fitness value for each search agent. Here, sphere function is used to compute the fitness value for each search agent. And after that, we will memorize the best solution in the population. Here, best means the optimum value. And right now, for the fourth V, you can see this is the best solution. Now, set the counter 1, and the maximum here we have 100. So, we will repeat this loop until stopping criteria is met. Step 4, now we will compute the initial fitness factor. Using initial fitness factor, we can compute the quality of the food sources. Here, we will check the fitness value if it is greater than or equal to 0, or this one is less than 0. If fitness value is greater than or equal to 0, then we will use this one, else this one. Now we are going to compute the initial fitness factor. So when the food sources are found by the bees, compute the fitness value for each, and after that we will measure the food source quality by the fitness values. So we are using this to measure the food source quality. Here you can see all the values are greater than 0. So we will use this one. For the first P, 1 divided by 1 plus its fitness value, that is 26.3331, and we got this one. This is the initial fitness factor that we computed for the first P. After that, for second B, 1 divided by 1 plus its fitness value, that is 168.2283, and we got initial fitness factor for this B, this one. For third B, put the fitness value here and compute this. For fourth B, we got this, and you can see we got all the initial fitness factor for each B. Now you can see here, best quality food source is this one, that is the higher value. Here we will check the higher value, and you can see among all we have this one is the higher value. Higher the value, it means better quality food source. Lower value, it means this is not good quality food source. Now in step 5, we will generate new solution for the employee bees from the old solution. Using this equation, here k is the random dimension index selected from the set 1 to n, and phi ik is the random number within minus 1 to 1, and this is the randomly selected candidate solution, this one. Now using this equation, we generated new solution for the employee bees. After that, we will evaluate the fitness value for each B using the fitness function, and you can see we got the fitness values. After that, again we will compute the initial fitness vector for each, and you can see all the values are greater than 0, so we will use this one. So for each B, we will compute the fitness vector, and we got this for each B. Now we will apply here the greedy selection process. In this process, if the nectar amount of new solution, that is here, is higher than the older one, then the B memorize the new and forget the old solution. So we will compare the new solution and the old solution. If the new solution value is higher than the lower one, than the older one, then we will choose new and forget old one. So in this step, we will apply greedy selection. If the fitness value for the new solution is better than the old solution, then we will update old solution with new, else we will keep older unchanged. Here you can see for the first B, older solution value is greater than new, so it will remain unchanged. For the second B, new value that we got is greater than the old solution. So here we will exchange xi with vi. As we know, if new solution is higher than the older one, the B memorize the new and forget the old solution. So in this case, we will consider this. And again, for third B, this value is greater than this one, so we will consider this solution. And for the fourth B, older solution is better than the new, so we will update only second and third solution, and this is the higher, so we will update here and here in the population, in the initial fitness factor and the fitness value. And you can see we updated all. After that, we have next phase for the follower V's. Here we will evaluate the nectar information taken from employee bees and choose the food source with the probability related to its nectar amount. And here left peel mechanism is used for probabilistic selection. So we will compute the probability value for the solution that we computed before. Using this equation, we can compute the probability value. In better solution have higher probability of being chosen or exploration. And why this we got different probability values for each B. Now using this equation, we will produce new solution for the follower Bs from the previous solution selected using probability values. And you can see we updated position, fitness value and the fitness factor. After that, again we will apply the greedy selection. Here we will compare the older updated fitness factor with the new updated fitness factor. If new fitness factor value is greater than the older one, then we will update, else it will remain unchanged. Right now in this case, all the older values are greater than the new solution, so it will remain unchanged. And in the end, you can see we have best solution 0.0408. This one is the position and the fitness value for this. Then increment the counter and we will repeat the loop until the stopping criteria is met. For the scout B phase, B with the higher fitness value have greater chance to continue its own exploration. So here, bees can explore their own food sources. You can see this is the output, and here we got the fitness value of the 100 iteration, that is 1.2278. So that's all about this algorithm. First we will initialize the population randomly. After that, compute the fitness value, memorize best solution, set the counter, generate new solution for employee bees, compute fitness value and fitness factor, compute the probability for each solution. Then we will generate the new solutions for the follower bees, compute the fitness value, fitness factor, apply greedy selection, and after that we will keep the best solution found in the population, increment the counter, and we repeat the loop until the stopping criteria is matched. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.